Hello and welcome to Jaisalmer. This is a city that has a government approved bhang shop and I tried to purchase some bhang. Bhang milega?
Haan ji, bhang milega.
So bhang de do aap.
Theek hai. So we have bhang chocolate.
Bhang nahi hai. And I pretended like it was an inconvenience, but it really wasn't because I had to mix it in the chocolate in any case.
So 250 gram chocolate de do aap mujhe.
So now I'm going to use that bhang chocolate to make some Christmas bhang recipes.
Yeah. 250 gram chocolate. Your ticket for the moon. Okay, see you on the moon.
Thank you, sir. Welcome to another episode of Going Green. We are here this time for Christmas recipes. This time to make bhang chocolate brownies. We are going to need brown sugar, butter, flour, the bhang chocolate, which is the MVP of this day, dark chocolate, milk chocolate, to hold it all together, eggs, that's right. And you are going to need some baking soda. For the end, you're going to need walnuts, okay? Now that we're done with the ingredients, let me tell you what to do. First, you're going to preheat the oven. If you're like Mikhail Vand, you're going right now to preheat the oven. It is preheating as we speak. And so now you're going to have to get to work with the ingredients. What you're going to have to do is you're going to have to double boil the three chocolates and the butter. Now you're like, Mikhail, does that mean I have to boil the chocolates and put it out to cool and then boil it again? No. Double boil. You're going to have to like put water in your frying pan, then put your chocolate and the butters in the bowl. It's truly a piece of art that I am creating right now. I'm going to put this on to double boil. We have still not put this granite that he has sold me in the name of bhang chocolate. But I can't add like this, it'll take a lot of time to melt and I don't have that much time. Gotta eat, gotta go out, gotta see the world like a fool and like carry on. I have this pizza cutter, I had to rob this from an actual Italian. There are lots of them in Rajasthan. I didn't disturb the balance so much. So, it's fine. And you start chopping, start with the edges, okay? And you can just break it down like this. Are you seeing this? My God. And just because I'm stylish, one cross cut also. Boom. So now I'm going to add this to... The butter has started to melt. And there are still some small pieces of chocolate left to melt. We're going to have to let this go on for some more time. We shall move on to the next process. We'll break two eggs and mix it with the brown sugar. Okay. Now it looks like the sand dunes in Rajasthan. Check this out. Sand dune. This is what they look like. It's the tiniest egg. I don't know what sparrows they're eating in Rajasthan. This is not the usual size of a chicken egg. And I'm gonna get to whisking the eggs with the sugar. Check it out. I didn't know this, but every ingredient in a brownie eventually looks brown only. The egg was the only thing that was not brown, and now that is also brown. I'm gonna check on the chocolate. You gotta keep checking on the chocolate, man. There's no other way to do it. Sometimes the chocolate doesn't melt as fast. I'm gonna take some flour, okay? I have to add 1 teaspoon of baking soda now, so I'm gonna put in the flour. I'll just stir it around in the flour bowl. Let's take this off the boil. I think this is done. And now, time for safety. So, I have this, and I need... Not goalkeeper. Okay, so it's a very hot bowl, so just be careful about messing around with it, okay? I'm gonna have to mix the brown sugar and the eggs with the chocolate, okay? So I have to mix these well before I add the flour. Now, as you can see, this bowl is kind of becoming full. So before I add the flour, I'll do it in another bowl. I'm first gonna empty the chocolate and eggs into it. Oh my God. I have a knack for creating beautiful visuals. I'm gonna add the flour and the baking soda really slowly, okay? This is done to avoid clumps. So, yeah, look at this, I'm using a measuring spoon like a shovel. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna do it a little at a time and mix it. So, now is when you're gonna need strength, okay? Because it's becoming very, very thick and it's gonna get more and more difficult to mix like this. When you started, it was like just chocolate melting and that looked very good. But now it's very thick. This is approximately how you want it to look. Everything looks well mixed in. There are no clumps, nothing. This is how you want it to fall by the end of it. And so now we're going to set it in the tray. You're wondering, because we have the walnuts right now, man. You're supposed to have walnuts. Yeah, I know. I'll put it in the end. Because otherwise it sinks to the bottom if you put it in the mix. And then you have crunchy bottomed but soggy bottomed brownies. You want crunchy top and soggy bottom. Only in brownies, not in your life. Now I'm going to set it in the tray. If you can get one of those baking trays where the bottom comes off like this. And while this is a brand new non-stick thing, I will still line this with butter. So for that, what you need is you need a brush. You need some softened butter. And just take the brush and paint an original Mikhail. It's worth a lot of money in all currencies. I don't make just 2D paintings, okay? I make 3D paintings, so also on the walls. The art doesn't stop. So now I'm going to set the chocolate in the tray, okay? I'll show you how much to put. Because if you pour it to the rim, what will happen, it'll puff and then you will have a tray in a brownie. That's what, no one wants to do that. Okay, so let gravity do its work. Okay, I'm going to take this, just set it around. Okay, so now that I've set it, as you can see, I've not filled it to the brim. I'm going to put some walnuts now. Let's see how that looks. As you can see, it's not sinking now, so it'll stay at the top. So I'm just going to add the last few. I have to place this in the oven now. But as you know, safety first. So do not lift up from the bottom, because then the bottom just comes right through and you have a brownie mess. Hold it on the two sides and take it to the oven. Okay, and so. That is it. Now we're going to let it sit for about 20 to 25 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. Hopefully by the end of it, we should have some bhang chocolate brownies, man. Quite excited. Let's see how this turns out. Okay, alright, so I've been waiting 20 minutes now. It looks like it's quite done. The top has risen. But we'll take it out. We'll let it sit for about 10 minutes and then we'll come and test it. Sit. So now it's been about 20 minutes since I have taken it out of the oven. I've let it cool. I have cut it into very artistic pieces, as you can see. A lot of thought went into this shape. I'm going to try this and see how it is, okay? Breaks well, doesn't stick. I'm very, 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 to be modest, proud of myself. All those berries were for modest. I saw some camels on the way here. If I can ride them or something, it'll be fun. I'm still playing it safe. I'm having one piece and like a bit more because it's quite tasty. I'll get away from myself, don't worry. Okay, I'll see you in an hour. Been an hour. It's quite nice. I'm quite relaxed. I'm very comfortable. That's all. I really want. Can we do those camels? Look, Ma. No hands. Oof. Dude, what are you doing, dude? Oof. Calm down.